Barely a month ago, the country experienced a shortage of petrol that saw fuel station raising pump prices to the average of 5,000 shillings per litre. But Uganda Revenue Authority has said the country imports 6.5 million litres of petrol daily, of which only 6 million litres are consumed by Ugandans. This means an excess of 500 litres that can cover gaps at stations. The tax body is baffled by fuel stations that are still striking petrol prices and those crying out about scarcity.
Was a strike by the drivers because of the protocol, the demand to have COVID tests done, and that caused no entry of trucks, especially for Malaba border. That also took some time to resolve, but we thank government that finally the East African governments came together and resolved that issue. So from 11th, Abel, you can confirm the date, of January, that strike was resolved. And when that strike was resolved, immediately URA was set and all the other agencies of government at Malaba, even Busia, expedite clearance of traffic, because now the traffic had built up to the longest jam was 75 kilometers. Now, given that every kilometer holds about 50 trucks, so 75 times 50, you can imagine the thousands of trucks. And the roads are narrow. You could not say even prioritize fuel to come through because fuel was running low or something.
While Uganda Revenue Authority presented its half-year result performance for the period running July to December 2021, the body estimated 2.5 trillion shillings collection from the oil and gas sector.
Information and communication sector came in the fourth position and it contributed 880.97 billion, which is approximately 8.55%. The public administration sector contributed about 3.7%. Now, the revenue growth in wholesale and retail mainly came from the fuels and related products. The growth in the financial sector came from mainly the transfer of mobile money under regulations by the Bank of Uganda.
Meanwhile, Uganda Revenue Authority posted 900 billion shortfall in revenue collection for the first half of 2021-2022 financial year. This, however, was a 91.8% score performance according to its target document for the financial year running. Although this was a better performance compared to last financial year, it is still far below the 2018-2019 mark, largely due to the COVID-19 pandemic that has disrupted economic and social activities for about 2 years. According to the URA Commissioner General, the performance casts a ray of hope for stronger performance in the last half of the year, given the full reopening of the economy early this year. This as he released the half-year performance results at the URA head office in Kampala.
A look at the indirect taxes, ladies and gentlemen. The indirect taxes collections for the same period of July to December 2021 were 2.296 trillion against a target of 2.783 trillion, therefore registering a performance of 82.5% and a shortfall of 487.2 billion. However, as indicated earlier, there is still a growth compared to the same period last year of 6.35%.
In the current financial year, URA was given a target of 22.363 trillion, about 16% increment compared to last financial year. Over the last half of the year, the taxman was projected to collect 11.063 trillion, which is a difference of 1.59 trillion compared to the same period last year. According to Rejoki, net revenue collection for the first half of 2021-2022 was 10.163 trillion against a target of 11.063 trillion, leaving a shortfall of 900.8 billion.